Hey guys, what's up? It's Derek. So I know I haven't recorded a video in quite a while. To be honest, this is a tough time of year for me. I'm usually gone on trips and just not usually in my studio room. So I do apologize for that. I promise though that I'll have more videos coming very soon. And there's been some changes as well. So real quick, before I get into the video, I wanna show you guys or introduce you to somebody new.
What's going on in here?
So,
Mev, look, Mev, look, baby, look.
So this is Memphis. He is our new puppy. So as you can imagine, this has been where a lot of my time has been going.
I'm gonna let him out quick.
So that's where, I know that was quick, but he's about to go on his walk. So he's a little antsy, but he's our 14-week golden doodle, and we are completely obsessed with him. But as you can imagine, that's been a significant amount of my time the last month as well. So I think we've had him for 6 weeks. So he's a good pup, and you'll probably see him in some more of the future videos as well. But anyways, into the video. So the song I'm gonna do today was one that was pretty heavily requested based on the comments that I was seeing. And I know that I haven't been, you know, active the last couple of months, but I still do read your comments. And again, I promise that I'm gonna start putting out more videos. So the first one I'm gonna do is Betty by Taylor Swift. It looks like she played this at the Academy of Country Music Awards acoustically. I still have not listened to a lot of the songs on that album for the sake of this channel. So I know that there's a lot of catching up for me to do, but this seems to be the one that's the most commented or most requested. And so yeah, I'm gonna try and teach you guys how to play it like she does in this video. This actually looks very similar to the Cornelia Street like setup with the lighting and stuff. And she's playing a Gibson, so right away, guys, I can tell that the song is in the key of C. And so your guitar will be in standard tuning. And so that first verse, you know, where she starts, "Betty, I won't make assumptions." That first chord is a C major. And then what I think she's doing is she does what I refer to as like the walk down to that A minor. So you go from C to the B over C, or C over B, either way you wanna, whatever you wanna call it, to an A minor, to a G. And she did this G in another recent video I did where she just basically puts her ring finger on the sixth string of the third fret and just leaves everything else open on that G. And it sounded like she did a little hammer on with her pointer finger, second string of the first fret. And then she went to an F. And then back to the G. So that part is the, based on the lyrics, is considered the pre-chorus. But the first half of that pre-chorus was played the same way as the verse. So what I can tell, guys, is like, in terms of, you know, you had those chords that I went over. So C, C over B, A minor, G, F, back to G. For strumming, what it sounds like she's doing is just like a... something like that, where she like, it almost sounds like she picks the first two, like the first two strings and then strums. I think, let me rewind this and make sure. Yeah, so she's doing something like that. So basically what I'm doing is I'm picking the fifth and fourth string. and then strumming. Down, up, and then I switch to the next chord. Same thing there. Same thing on the A minor. There I go 6 and 4 for the picking in the right hand. And then I think on the F and the G, she doesn't really pick as much. She just does like a... So something like that. The other thing you could do is just... It's just like down strums. So you could do that too. I wouldn't get too focused on the picking, but I believe that's what she's doing. excuse me, that's what she's doing there. And then it changed. So the pre-chorus starts on "You heard the rumors" from Inez. You can't believe a word she says. Most times this time it was true. Most times, but this time it was true. And then on "The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you," she switched it up there. So let me.
What she says most times, this time what it's true.
A minor. Okay, so for that part so far, and it sounds like she's starting to pick it up to go into the chorus, she went A minor to G. Worst thing that I ever did. C to F was what I did. And she is starting to just do down strums on that F. I'm gonna bet that she goes back to the G right before the chorus.
But if I just show up at your party, would you hide me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go straight to hell? Or lead me to the garden in the garden?
So that's those aren't the actual words, are they? That's the PG version. So again, guys, I haven't heard the song, but the lyrics do not say what she just said.
Garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing?
She knows it too.
Only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you. But if I just show...
So that part right there. She just does down strums and then slaps the strings with her right hand. And now she goes into the verse, or sorry, the chorus, which is played the same way as the verse, at least for the first half, I think. C, oh, C over B, A minor, G, F. Oh, okay. So she did change it up there a little bit. She went back to the A minor and then to the G for the chorus. So she went C, C over B, A minor, G, F, A minor, G. And she probably repeats that. Love that harmonica. Yeah, so again, yeah, the chorus is almost the same thing. Even the strumming pattern is very similar with the picking until the end when she goes, "But I know I miss you." She kind of picks it up there and actually does the strumming that I say you could do instead of the picking, where it's just more down strum. So it's... So something like that. And now I believe she is into the second verse. So
Eddie, I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite song was playing from far side of the gym. I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus I saw you dance with him. You heard the
all of this is the same still. So all of that is the same as the first verse and pre-chorus. And now you're into the second chorus. Okay, this is the bridge now. So that was the bridge, and the first thing I think of, guys, and I know I've harped on this a ton in my other Taylor Swift videos that I've done, that bridge is like a perfect example of her really mixing up lyrically, melodically, and even, you know, guitar playing wise, the song to get your attention back into the song. So, you know, the first verse, the first pre-chorus and chorus, second verse, second pre-chorus, second chorus, they all were pretty similar. You played them almost the same way on the guitar. And then that bridge, it changed, you know, almost completely. I mean, not completely. Everything is still in the same, you know, same chords, same key. But the tempo and everything changed in terms of her playing too. So I use the word dynamics a lot when playing guitar. Because an amateur guitarist, or one of the first signs of an amateur guitarist is someone that just plays at the same level, the same consistency for the whole song. And I've always said that that's one of the things that Taylor does so well. She is so good at capturing your attention and you know, bringing you in and out. And that's exactly what she just did there in that bridge. Let me rewind this so I can show you guys how to play it. A minor. G. So, broken ghost, don't just think about you. I think that's what she did. She missed. I was walking home. Broken cobbles of my worst intentions. She said. Yeah. So she goes A minor to G to F to C and then back to G. And the strumming is going to sound something like this. Something like that. It's all down strums, and she's muting with her right hand, and she switches it up a little bit because on the F she goes two down strums, two on the C, and then back to the G. So, and then it sounds like when she goes, she said, "James, get in, let's drive." It changes up a little bit again here too. James, get in, A minor. G. F. So that part, she just did the down strums, the muted down strums, and she went.
She said, "James, get in, let's drive. Those days turned into nights. Slept next to her, but I dreamt of you all summer long."
So she's going A minor to G. Again, she plays G like this. She can play it any way you want, really. If you want to sound like her, it's more of this. And then she goes F, and then to G for that part. And then it sounds like, you know, you're into the third verse now, and it sounds like she's playing the same, you know, that walk down pattern again. So here's a little instrumental. Same thing though, she picked up the strumming a little bit. And then at the end of that, she went A minor, G, and just like single strums, very very aggressive for that part. Third verse. All the same here. A minor G, C, F. Emotion, man.
Yeah, I showed up at your party. Will you have
so
me?
Key change. So for that final chorus, guys, she actually made a key change, which I love to see that. That used to be done all the time back in the 80s and 90s and even the early 2000s with in pop music. But for some reason, I swear, I can't think of a current Billboard song that has a key change like that. So maybe I'm totally off on that, but it seems like that used to be a thing used pretty often in music. Again, part of the dynamics and switching things up to grab that attention again. That's an awesome tool to incorporate in your songs, is just upping the key. So she actually went up from the key of C, up a full step to the key of D. So let's rewind this real quick. Yeah, so same chord intervals here, but now you're in the key of D, so you go D. This is a C sharp over D, I think. So that's a little bit of a stretch, but all you do is you put your pinky finger on the fourth fret of the fifth string. And then it's a B minor. I would play it like this, because it's gonna be an easier switch. Your ring finger stays anchored there. Then to an A. It's an A sus because this finger stays there as well. I think that's an A sus too. Again, I'm not really technical in terms of that stuff, guys, but this is the A shape you want. G, F sharp over D, E minor 7, and then back to that A. And same strumming pattern too. So. That's kind of what she's doing for that key change. But I mean, if you look at the chord intervals, they stay the same, you know, like it's just everything's moved up one full step. Yeah, and in that part, she just goes D, A to G. And the strumming pattern is something like that. Or maybe it's something like So I'm just going down, 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 up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, down. And I think she went back to the A there too for a brief second. Man, I wish and I hope that she really comes out with more of this stuff. I know that she's like a huge pop star now, but I think the reason a lot of people fell in love with Taylor Swift is because of performances like this, where like she is one of the few people that can just strip everything down acoustically and make a performance just so encompassing like that. I mean, it's just, it's something to honestly study. Like if you, you know, if you are wanting to be a performer or even a writer, you know, because at her core, Taylor's a writer. And you can tell that, you know, you can tell that she sings the songs that she writes, because there's always this thing, like when there's a an artist that's recording a song that somebody else wrote, you can always tell, you know, like they don't have that connection with the song. And that's one of the things that she has on her side. One of her many strengths is that she can convey exactly what she was feeling when she wrote that song through just her voice and her guitar. And that's a powerful thing. So anyways, enough T-Swift ranting. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I'm sorry again for the delay in videos. I promise that I'm getting back into it. Honestly, the next month is tough for me. Really the next 2 months, but I'm gonna make it a goal of mine to try and release a video at least every week. So at least one. And then honestly, after the new year, I'm gonna hit the ground running again and be putting out 3 to 4 videos a week. So yeah, thanks for the suggestion. Let me know in the comment section below what other songs I should do this with. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.